We're in.
We will open this meeting of April 11th, 2013. Let the record show all selectmen are present. At this time, I would like to go into a non-public session for RSA 91A:3, personnel.
Second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Do we have a roll call vote, please?
Yes.
Yes.
Here.
Yes. Yes, that's what they did last night.
Yeah, here.
Yep.
I make a motion, we seal the minutes of the non-public as they pertain to personnel permanently.
Second. All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes.
All right. Okay. I have some things that we have to go over before we do the selectmen's reports. A lot of things in the FYI. This is a memo from Board of Selectmen Cindy Reinhardt's. Last year, Kim's attended the first year of town clerk's tax collector certification classes. Unfortunately, I neglected to include the second year costs in this year's budget. Would it be possible if the board could possibly absorb the cost in their budget? And I'm going to pass that down.
No.
No.
I make a motion first.
All right.
I would make a motion that...
Last year, Kim's attended?
Yes. I would like to make a motion that due to budget constraints, that we are unable to support in our budget the school for Kim this year.
I already know.
Second.
This motion and second. Anybody, any discussion on it?
I just want to make absolutely clear that we're denying the request to send her to the school.
Because of budget constraints, correct.
Okay.
Yes. All right. All those in favor of the motion?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. All right. This is a memo from Chief Ober. As we wind down winter and are transitioning into spring, this is a good time to review our winter emergency response statistics, which includes December 1st, 2012 to March 31st, 2013. Our incidents are slightly lower than the previous year for the same period. We responded to 467 emergency calls for the four-month period. We responded to 482 emergency calls during the same period in 2011-2012. There were 48 simultaneously or back-to-back emergencies. 57% of these emergencies had an arrival time on scene within 6 minutes or less. Our overall average time was 6.37 minutes. 22% of all emergencies were between the hours of 11 p.m. and 8 a.m. Our busiest time was the 3 p.m. time period at 8.56% of all emergencies. 9 a.m., 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., and 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. was our second busiest time period, averaging 6% of all emergencies. We responded to 14 fires in a building and 9 chimney fires with an estimated property loss of $420,420. Our comparison of medical and fire-related emergencies was 62.9% medical and 37.1% fire. Our breakdown by town is Northfield 162, Tilton at 261, and automatic or mutual aid at 44. We treated 284 patients during this period. 51% received advanced life support, 21% received basic life support, 16% refused treatment, 10% were treated, however, refused transport, and 2% were transported by another agency. In December, we treated a cardiac arrest patient, which, due to the efforts of bystanders, our personnel, and newly purchased medical equipment, experienced return of spontaneous circulation This patient was transferred to Concord Hospital for follow-up cardiac treatment, and I am pleased to report he has returned to our community enjoying a normal lifestyle.
Good for them.
Great job.
Mm-hmm.
We have a meeting, a public notice for a meeting discussing the availability of the analysis of brownfield cleanup alternatives report for a portion of the environmental cleanup to be conducted at the Ernie's Auto Sale property for public review and comments. The meeting is Monday, April 15th, during the regularly scheduled Town Conservation Commission meeting at the Tilton Town Office at 7 p.m. There is part-time help wanted. Individuals, Town of Tilton Parks Commission, seasonal part-time laborer, position available. Individual is responsible for performing general maintenance duties approximately 3 days a week, 8 hours per day, at Riverfront Park. Duties are assigned by the Tilton Parks Commissioners. Compensation based on experience. Application forms and job description are available at the Tilton Town Hall, 257 Main Street, Tilton, New Hampshire. Any questions concerning this position shall be directed to Robert Hardy, Chairman, Tilton Parks Commission, via email axman@yahoo.com. All interested applicants should submit an application form or resume to the attention of the Tilton Parks Commission in an envelope marked confidential and addressed to Tilton Parks Commission, 257 Main Street, Tilton, New Hampshire, 03276, no later than 4 p.m. on May 3rd, 2013. And is the Summer Parks program, is that on the website?
I don't know.
We should have it on the website.
When did we get that? Just Tuesday, right? Wednesday?
We have free summer parks program. June 15th is a wild center and zoological park. Riverfront Park, 11 to 2. July 19th, bats in your yards. Learn about bats and how to encourage them. Riverfront Park, 7 to 8 p.m. Bring your own lawn chair. July 20th, nature walk in Buffalo Park. Learn about trees and wildlife in the park, 9 to 12. Bring bug spray and sturdy footwear. August 23rd, wildlife showing. Learn about New Hampshire wildlife, Riverfront Park, 7 to 8 p.m. Bring your own lawn chair. August 23rd, Festival of Pets, pet show. Bring your own pet and show it off. 132 Ballfield, 9 to 12. Watch the town website for more info. September 20th, Bobcats. Learn about New Hampshire Bobcats, Riverfront Park, 7 to 8 p.m. Bring your own lawn chair. Please check the town website for more information and programs that may be added, evening shows, rain or shine. On Saturday, April 13th, we'll be host the Tilton PD. We'll be hosting a spaghetti dinner at the Greenside Restaurant located at Lockmere Country Club. Dinner is from 3 to 5 and 5 to 7. From 7 to 11, Freddie Partridge and his band will be playing to help the benefit. Tickets are $10 at the door. There will be a silent auction during all three times. Please let people know. This is from the chief. And on Friday, this Friday, the 12th, is Uno's Help for Nate fundraiser all day at the Tilton Uno's Chicago Grill, 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. on all sales, insider takeout. Customers will need to present one of these tickets to their waitress or waiter. Please help raise the dough for a great cause. So you need to
print out that ticket?
Right. Anybody that wants to stop in and get one of these tickets before you go to Uno's, you just give this to the waitress, and a portion of the meal goes to help for Nate. Saturday, there's a car wash also in the morning from 9 to 11?
I think it's like 10 to 2.
10 to 2 at AutoServe to benefit help for Nate. Last Saturday was the Flapjack fundraiser, which the Tilton Senior Center gladly shared with help for Nate. The Senior Center raised $1,400 for the Tilton Senior Center. And there were additional, we split the, it was overwhelming, overwhelming, the amount of people that showed up. And Nate was $2,026, because there was people that came, $2,126, because people came in and made specific donations to Nate. But there was almost 400 people. Easy. I'd like to make a motion that we accept the donation from the Pearsons for the Tilton Senior Center.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Tomorrow, we have at 2 p.m., a police officer will be graduating from the Police Standards and Training at 2 o'clock, if anybody would like to attend.
Is that where we went the last time?
Yep. The chief and I are driving down 1 o'clock from the PD, if you'd like to come.
All right. Pat and the chief riding along down the street with Joe in the back. Like, what's going on?
They don't have a cage in the chief's car.
Oh. Yeah, really?
Okay. All right. I have one request for Hawkers and Peddlers, but this is a woman that owns Mountaintop Trailers on 454 West Main Street. She'd like a hot dog cart right at her place. And given what we did last week with the snow cone, it's on her own property, so she wouldn't need a Hawkers and Peddlers, correct?
Typically in the past, that's what this Board of Selectmen has done. If they own their own property, they're already paying taxes, and they've theoretically gone through the site planning process.
Okay, so...
So we don't usually...
Yeah, but that's not... A trailer is not a hot dog cart.
Well, A jewelry store isn't a snow cone, but it's their property,
yeah,
and it's their business.
Yeah, yeah.
They're already paying taxes. They've gone through the site plan process. It's not like somebody that comes from out of town and all of a sudden sets up business. Not paying taxes, not site planning. Just
I would agree with this one. They're paying taxes. The jewelry store is not paying taxes.
No, somebody is.
Well, they're paying rent, so their rent is going towards taxes.
Some of it, yeah.
We have... did you want to do your... Did you want to do the applications to your selectmen's report, Joe, for recycling, and Catherine for parks, or do you want to... Let me just rattle them off now, and
you can go ahead. I didn't.
No, you can. You can definitely rattle them now.
That's the minutes.
Oh,
the meeting that
allowed them.
There was discussion. They accepted, and everybody was in favor of them. And the motion was made to reappoint.
Okay, then I would. Are these 3-year terms or?
I believe those two are.
Okay.
Yes, they are.
Mine are.
Those are 3-year terms because they both ended this year.
Okay. So I'll make a motion to appoint Peter Fogg, William Lawrence.
Just the two.
To the Parks Commission for a 3-year term.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Abstain.
One abstention. You can start the signatures there. I would like to... How many are we going to have on the recycling? I mean, I think it's a great, great idea, but...
One, Janine Mattinen is going from alternate to full-time member. Dennis Allen is also due to have his renewed, but he's been on vacation, so I haven't had that one. The others are alternates,
okay,
of which we would have none if Janine went to full-time status.
Okay. I will make the following motion for... Do you have the minutes?
You know, quite frankly, I haven't typed them up yet.
But they did meet and discuss it and vote to appoint?
Absolutely. And I'm the secretary. I'm the guy that would have done those minutes, but that particular meeting, I haven't, that particular meeting, I haven't got typed up yet.
So when you get a...
I will submit the copy to Joyce. I always do. I send Joyce a copy anyway.
Yes, he does.
Go ahead and do it.
Very good.
Yeah.
Actually, we're current, except for that one, and we've been meeting every week.
Okay, I'll make the following motion then, to accept the, to make appointments for a three-year term to the recycling, Tim Pearson as an alternate, Scott Davis for a three-year term, and Janine Mettenden for recycling for a three-year term.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Aye. Yes.
Aye. Yeah, aye.
And I will get those minutes typed up and sent to you directly, Joyce.
Okay. Okay. I have one other note here that says that the Tilton School, I'm assuming that it's the Tilton Prep School, is very interested in becoming involved in the simple, the single stream recycling pickup. Please call.
Catherine, could you pass that down to me? I will take care of that tomorrow morning.
What does that mean?
They would like to become involved in the recycling community.
Maybe they want bins. I don't know yet. I don't know exactly what it means. They want to become involved, and I'll explore.
Aren't they considered, don't they have a commercial hauler pick their stuff up?
They have an elsewhere.
Interesting.
I don't know what their level of involvement is going to be, or potentially, but I would bring that back to the board next week once I find out, and then we can talk about that.
I have one letter from a resident that I'd like to read and comment. These are your things here. To Pat Constantino, Chairman of the Board of Selectmen, dear Ms. Constantino, on Thursday, April 4th in the Winnesquamack Echo, I noticed an article about a public hearing with business owners along Tilton Main Street. Mm-hmm. I am writing to express my disappointment in not being included in the handful of merchants who were apparently selectively invited to discuss issues unique to their locations and busy downtown section of Tilton. It is my opinion that our town is not so large, nor are the businesses in this area so numerous as to warrant picking and choosing who will and will not be included. That being said, I would like to request that in the future I be included in discussions that have a direct impact on my livelihood. If I am incorrect in my assumption of how the invitations to this meeting and information about this meeting were dispersed, please contact me to correct me. Thank you for your attention in this matter. And this is from the P4 consignment, Kim. Now, Kim, my understanding was here during the time when we said we would get together and we picked the date in which we got together, and we said March 28th, we're going to get together during the selectmen's meeting and that. And she's closed on Mondays, and you didn't go on Monday, but you went on Monday, on Tuesday.
Wednesday.
Wednesday to drop off the note.
Know she didn't get one.
I have a note that Joyce is willing to contact her, but I have tried 3 days now to go and contact her. I don't have a home phone. I know where she lives, but I don't have a home phone number for her. All I have is the business, and I've gone in personally twice to see her, and she's not there, and I've called 3 times.
Wow.
So
I had 2 business owners from the east side of town ask why they were excluded.
Really? Well,
not included.
But that particular meeting was about the downtown.
Right, the downtown.
That's why they wanted to know why they were excluded because, and I quote, I'm a business in the town of Tilton. I'm on Route 311. Why are the Main Street businesses more special than I am?
Wow.
Well, it's just the unique problems we have right on the main street. That was
I think if the discussion had just stayed to the trash pickup.
Right.
Because that's really the one unique thing they do have. They probably would not have commented the way they did to me. But then I understood.
We went through a lot of different. Right.
That it was an open meeting for the businesses to discuss whatever problems they had. I didn't realize that it had evolved into that. I thought it was just going to be a continuation, so I was caught off guard and probably sounded a little stupid because I didn't know the meeting had changed.
So I'm going to put this in the to be signed here so that you can have it to refer back. I'll pass that down. I think there's something else to sign there, too. The one good thing about the letter, though, is that we do have her email. So Joyce has created an email group for the downtown businesses, and people have been emailing me with their emails, email addresses, and I've been forwarding them to Joyce. So it goes right in that folder.
As far as the recycle committee members, Cindy swears them in, Catherine?
Yes, they go to Cindy.
You can swear them in.
Right.
Well, if Cindy's here, I'll just have them do it all at once.
Exactly.
If she's not, I'll do it.
Yep. You just have to make certain that they go to her.
Yeah.
Once they're sworn in.
Yeah, the paperwork has to go to her. There's
and
a place for her to
sign. And they have to sign, and you have to sign.
Mm-hmm.
And you need to write in the terms.
Yep. I'll take care of it.
They're meeting, the park commissioner's meeting on the 22nd. I don't want to take the originals right now, in case I lose them. Okay, if you could put them in a folder in your office, and I'll try to remember
actually,
to pick them
Catherine,
up.
Actually, Catherine, if that they're all set, give them back to me, and I'll bring them to the recycle committee to finish.
Catherine, did we, Joyce, did we ever get anything back on the... The gentleman that created a berm across the road or a speed bump across the road and
yeah, I mean, I know that they're looking at some RSAs, but none of the ordinances fit with the sand. So,
well, actually, we do. The 2008 one, I thought, did.
Well, not for the littering one. Didn't work and did. They're using an RSA disorderly.
No, Joyce, the RSA that you and I looked at this morning?
Right. When I talked with the chief about it, he said that it doesn't specifically address sand. It talks about snow, ice, and water.
Yeah.
I thought it also generally said or any other. Do you have it?
Yeah.
If they block the road with garbage cans, we'd go and do something about it.
It's called snow, ice, obstructions. No person shall put or place or cause to be placed, put or placed, any snow or ice upon the surface of the travel portion of any town class 5 or 6 road for any purpose, except to provide a place necessary for crossing, recrossing, and traveling upon said highway by sleds, logging, or farm equipment. The second one was obstructing water. No person shall place or suffer to be placed or to remain any logs, earth, or other substances within the limits of a town road or upon land in the vicinity of a highway by which the water in a stream, pond, or ditch is turned upon the highway and injures or renders it unsuitable for public travel.
Wouldn't you agree that that dirt across the road would have caused any water shedding off that road or from the ditch to be altered, dammed up?
It's a dam in the road.
Right, but you're not flowing water onto the road. You're not causing water.
It says
water
ditch,
to be flowed on the road.
But it would have. If it had rained,
right,
the ditch would have become ineffective, and the sheeting action of the water off that road would have been, if it would have caused a dam effect.
You could argue that. I know they want to interview him. They went to his house three times so far.
You mean to tell me there's no law against putting up barriers in the road?
Do we need to?
Unless they're made of snow and ice?
No, these are just our town ordinance.
Yeah, we're just looking at town ordinance. There are RSAs.
There are RSAs.
Bag him on the RSA.
Before they charge him with the RSA, they want to interview him, and they went to his house three times, and the last time was 4 days ago. So I told Nate to let me know what they're going to charge him with. They're going to, I think, check with the county attorney, too. We just want to make sure he's going to be charged.
Ducks in a row, yeah.
The right criminal charge.
We want to use the right criminal charge.
We would have to cross out other.
Can't we give him a come to Jesus?
I'm not going to see Pat.
Well, the judge does that. We spoke to Paul Sanderson at LGC, and they suggested that the best route for the town to go would be to get a criminal charge against him under 236:39. And then once he's, you know, the judge says you're guilty, and then the prosecutor can ask for this. And Arthur had contacted the local contractor to get a price on what it would cost if a contractor was to pick
him. Yep.
And that came to $210. And then we made a subsequent call. Arthur called the contractor to make sure that, you know, how much it would cost to mobilize the equipment. And the contractor said that he had included that cost in his hourly price.
So it was $210. So that's what we're looking for him to reimburse us to for the equipment for the to go out. But what about the time and everything? That would have, that's all involved in the
no,
200.
And I would put, well, technically what we would do then is we would add on, it was two people for 1.5 hours, and I take their hourly rate, and then I
right.
add in all the benefits.
Yes.
Right down to workers' comp.
All right, so it's close to 300.
Yeah. And then the other thing Paul had said, and Catherine, I put in your folder, I made copies of the laws for you to give to the selectmen. That Paul Sanderson had cited two new statutes,
I showed it to Paul.
RSA 3139C and RSA 3139D, that we should take a good look at and have for next year's town meeting. Local ordinances and citations. And
no.
3139
No, I made a note on it.
Okay.
And then we also asked him to do an article in Town and City Magazine.
Yeah. Don't need to sign it.
It just needs to go back into the folder.
Yeah. Sandy's got it.
Because then we can do our own criminal.
Right. You can't do anything. Okay.
Back in the folder. There's one packet. I showed this to the chief earlier. That's Sandy. Jesus, legalized hemp so we'd stop killing trees.
Refuse littering.
Oh, that. Yeah.
So this leaves us as the administrative enforcement.
You can see how new these are. 2009.
Mm-hmm. Effective January 1.
They became effective 2010. Yeah. I think both of them are the same. Yep.
Wow.
Very, yeah, it's powerful stuff, so we need to have those definitely for warrant articles next year, and if by some weird happenstance we end up with a special town meeting this year, just throw them right in. Could we not, Joyce, have special town meeting just to enact these? Without, we don't, since we're not raising money, we don't have to. Oh, thank you.
Yeah, that's true, but there still is an expense because you have to have the supervisors to check.
Oh, sure.
You know, that, and then we'll be able to get, you know,
right.
But yeah, as long as it's appropriate.
We don't have to go to the Superior Judge. Okay. I didn't think so.
I'm still a little iffy about why we're utilizing the full force of the town and our enforcement powers over a pile of sand in the road. I understand it was a hazard of sorts, but it seems like maybe a simple conversation, or is this guy a person a problem?
Well, he cost the town money, for one thing.
Well, there is that.
It's a pretty malicious act. That put much of pile of sand all across the road, unexpected motorist. That could have been quite tragic.
Especially if I'd have hit it. It'd have been a tragedy.
If I'd gone down through there, I never would. I mean, I think I'm a pretty safe driver. But I never would have expected something like that. Thank
In
God
your
I have
truck,
a,
you wouldn't even have noticed
I know,
it.
I was a, I'd be like, thank God I have a truck.
What was that?
What was that hump? Well, Chuck.
Safety and the use of odd men
but
and
I think,
equipment.
Yeah, I think okay. I agree with Al. I think it's a huge safety issue.
Okay.
Yes.
Just the charge is 644-2, disorderly conduct, and it's creates a condition to place another in a public place by any action which serves no legitimate purpose. So that's a criminal charge that they're using. They went over on April 3rd at 7:30, April 6th at 7:40, and again on April 7th at 8:34. So they're just making a good faith effort to interview him before they drop a warrant. So that's where it's at now.
How long have you been over there?
Three.
April 7th was the third time.
Strikes out.
Well, while we're waiting for Pat to come back, why don't we go ahead and do the minutes, get them done? Start with March the 28th, and the legislative is dated April 4th.
Bring the minutes of March 28th to the 4th for approval.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Aye.
Catherine, on page 2, the second line down, it says you must have made premium payment contributions. Is that supposed to be 2011?
I think so.
Okay. Yeah. I just wasn't sure what the 2011 meant.
2011.
page five, chat committee. Right at the end, seconded by second LaPlante, period, all were. Indeed, all were. Page six, Dave Townsend, Eli Attic. 2, 4, 6, 8 lines down or so. He seems to feel the biggest issue is the amount of cigarette butts. Butts has two T's.
You see, I ought to come to my section of Route 311. Page 9. At 8:30 p.m., the board resumed their regular session. I said, don't kiss me.
What's going on at the top there? It says, Corporal Morrison reported that there are street lights out on Main Street and there was a safety issue.
Yes.
Joyce said Dennis has a list of the pole numbers and Corporal Morrison should let him know what pole lights are out, and he will contact PSNH. But then you turn it over on the back page, it's like something got repeated on it.
And the board still resumed their meeting at 8:30.
Yeah, and the board's still going.
Page 9 is printed on both sides of the sheet.
Yeah.
Sort of.
In its entirety.
No, the second page, 9, is off.
Is it shorter?
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah, by a line or something.
The first two lines are not there.
Right. I see.
Yeah. I vote. I make a motion to accept the minutes of March 28th as amended.
Second.
And now I'll vote.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Yes.
Aye.
Make a motion to bring the meeting of the selectmen.
I have a question, a couple questions on number two.
Oh, that's over with now.
Number two.
We have to get it on the floor first.
Okay.
Oh, no, on the ones we just corrected.
Oh,
they can wait until after we correct these if you want.
Yes, we're going to have to.
All right, fine.
Okay, then. In that case, I bring the minutes of the April 4th selectmen's meeting to the floor for discussion.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Yes. Aye.
It's been a long week.
Shouldn't the paragraph that says at 5:05 p.m. the board resumed have like...
The colon?
Yeah.
Or the,
semicolon,
whatever
it is.
Yeah.
Two dots?
Yep.
5:05 p.m.
A slush cone cart. That doesn't sound very appetizing.
Oh, I don't know.
Especially since that's what's going to be falling out of the sky tonight, tomorrow.
Yes.
Slush.
Slush.
shall they say.
Finance Officer Tim Pearson, third line, the firs year. Firs this year, like in fir trees. Does it have a T at the end, I think?
Yeah, firs this year.
Oh, yeah.
On page 2 under Chair Constantino, the very first line informed the board that Jane Alden has been selected to receive the 2013 Joseph D. Vaughn Award. First off, Ms. Alden, congratulations. Excellent, you're well deserving. I was at a Central New Hampshire Planning Commission meeting where it was also announced that you had won that award, and the wonder that was expressed that somebody from the town of Tilton had won that 3 years running. I can't even tell you how impressed they were with the commitment of the people of the town of Tilton to the senior population. On behalf of myself and I think everybody sitting here, congratulations.
Hear, hear.
Absolutely.
Job well done.
As an aside, I got a request from, I went to do somebody shopping today, and I got a text from somebody, and I said that's what I was doing. And this late 30s, early 40s person said, let me give you their list, my list, and you can do my shopping too. And I said, when you are over the age of 60, let me know, and I will be glad to do the shopping for you.
I know you will go to a shopping run. I'd give you my list.
That's right.
Page 2, last paragraph. Selectman Justman, the bags come in cases.
Yeah, you got that same thing at that Chair Constantino down at the end, on the, located on the same floor of the State House, I Concord.
In Concord.
You're
keep this in the last letter, Catherine.
That was I Concord, and then down below you go.
You'll be all right, Catherine.
Yes, you can.
It'll be all right.
Furs, board.
On the very top of page 2, the best way, Casella, it says Selectman Dawson asked why they did.
Yeah, that hurts.
Not rebid.
Yeah, that hurts.
It should be didn't.
Didn't rebid
did
or
not.
Not
rebid. Did not.
Right. Did not.
Second page, very last paragraph, they can be inserted, ED on insert. They can be insert, no. They can be insert any printed, oh, they can insert, leave out B.
Yeah, they can insert.
Oh, I didn't wear it. I should have. Joe would have been proud.
Did you have a bag shirt?
A plastic bag. I made one up.
Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. I think I'm going to have to go with that.
You did. Should have gotten a picture for the website.
I can put it back on.
We can work it out. We have more bags here.
I got my outfit downstairs.
It's not numbered. The third page, where at the top where it says Selectman Justman, there's a couple of beginnings of sentences that are not capitalized in that paragraph. Two they's.
Yeah, vendors of our choice. They also do the billing.
I Monthly report will be provided by location as to the amount of bags sold, monies collected, and any location that might be in arrears. Okay, it makes sense now. I had to read it out loud, sorry. Didn't make sense at first. I get it.
Thank God that was correct.
Good job, Captain.
Thank God.
So this person was at the meeting?
Now,
I'm
page number 4. Because it sounds odd.
What?
Page number 4. Fourth line. Chair Constantino read the oath of office to office to Officer Luke Pinault to the position of full-time corporal. It doesn't, I know what it is, but that doesn't necessarily make sense grammatically. To the position?
Of full-time corporal.
To the rank?
To the rank of full-time corporal?
Rather than position?
Well, I don't know.
It is a rank.
Read the oath of office to Officer Luke Pinault, promoting him to the position of full-time corporal? I don't know. I guess it makes no difference. It
makes sense.
You're right, though. We would understand it, but somebody who had
no idea.
Somebody's
going to look at that and go, wait a minute.
What happened?
What does that mean?
Promoting him to the rank of...
Or position of full-time corporal. Rank. It is a rank, right, Chief?
It's a rank.
It's a rank.
Okay. It's a rank. Is that like a rap?
Any more admissions or corrections or additions?
In the last paragraph on that sentence, Nate Buffington, the meritorious conduct, it should say medal there, award or medal there. And conduct should be capitalized as it is above.
Yeah.
Outstanding job on these minutes, Captain. That's all I got to say.
And I would like to make a motion that we rewrite the minutes of, that we approve the meeting minutes of 4/4/13 as corrected, amended, and rewritten.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Sorry, Captain.
Okay, now do I have to ask my question?
Now you can ask your questions, Captain.
It's moot at this point.
Well, they're approved,
Let
so...
Let me hold on to this. What is our water line project that's referred to on page 2? The Lakes Region Planning Commission has accepted the town's application, Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy. People can't attend. Attend the meeting in support of our water line project.
Remember a couple weeks ago I came to the board and I asked for permission to submit as a project extending the water distribution system up to Business Park Drive.
Yes.
And I used the information that back from the 2010
both probably
town meetings. Remember that was the year we had 3 meetings?
That's not a town project.
Well, it's a project in the town.
We don't own it.
Yeah, but the Planning Commission deals with projects in Tilton, whether they're whatever they are.
That the criteria?
Yeah.
Right, and it's a partnership. That's the good part of it, because the partners or the people that would be involved in this would be the water district, the town, and the property.
Town would have nothing to do with it.
Because?
We would have absolutely nothing to do with it.
Because we are a member of the Planning Commission,
we would have nothing to do with that project.
No, they're absolutely right. But the public, the Planning Commission is involved on behalf of the economic development of Tilton.
Right.
That would help develop Tilton.
Okay.
Because I talked with...
But was it submitted as a town project? Or a water district project?
Well, for everybody.
A project in the town.
And all the stakeholders.
I hope so, because...
Project in the town for economic development. That's what it is. It's not a town project.
Well, Casey Nickerson putting up a water tower has nothing to do with town, that it's going to benefit...
It'll have
the
something
town,
to do
because
with
it's going to benefit his park, but...
Economic development, and that's what this particular
okay,
thing
I just, I just hope it was presented correctly, because I have concerns.
Are you happy with what was presented?
I talked to Kim Poulette because I told him that the town was not involved in a water line project.
Right.
And he said this is about economic development within the town of
right.
Tilton,
right.
regardless of who actually was doing it. If somebody was building
okay.
a factory, that's economic development,
okay.
and they could then become involved.
Okay, good. The island. I'm a little confused by this paragraph. The intent of the contract is very clear that they wanted ownership shared between the town of Tilton and the town of Northfield, and that if either one gives it up, it goes back to the heirs.
Right.
So what our purpose is to ask the heirs if they would give us the right to own the island, since Northfield has expressed a desire to relinquish their claim on it. So I'm a little curious as why we're not going forward in that direction,
because I spoke with Joy Tilton and she said no, she wants the two towns to own it. She does not want one town to own it. That wasn't
right.
the intent of the heirs. And she said
right.
she will do whatever she can to have it so that Northfield participates in case in her chair.
Okay, that's not clearly spelled here. What it sounds like is that she's going before the town of Northfield, and we know the intent of at least the governing body over there is they don't want any part of the island. And if the town of Northfield votes to relinquish any ownership or responsibility in the island, it reverts back to the owners, which means Tilton can't own it either.
Right.
The intent of the Board of Selectmen in Northfield is to not have any financial responsibility.
Correct.
Thereby, they cannot own the island.
Right.
And if they give up their right, if Joy Tilton goes there and they give that up, we're done.
That's right.
Then other things kick in.
Well, it reverts back to the heirs.
That's
very
the other
clear.
Things that I'm
and we don't want that to happen.
No.
She doesn't want that to happen.
No.
Okay. All right, because that isn't expressed here. I'm glad to hear that. So,
no, so she's gonna
they're on the same page that we're on.
Yes, that it
all right.
needs to be.
That's excellent. Okay.
Going to spend time on making sure that it stays the two towns, that it does not.
Does she need any help from us?
Yeah.
Next.
Okay. I'm willing to do whatever she needs.
We're all willing to help.
Yeah. We're all willing to help.
Tell her that if she feels she needs backing from us at any meetings or whatnot, that
she's got it.
To let us know we're here.
We also have a new selectman over there, too, and we don't know how that new selectman, his ideas are reflected in this whole process either.
No, so. But we do know he's very frugal.
I'm a frugal guy, but... Not to spite, but spite myself or the residents in the town of Tilton.
Right.
And the new selectman seems to be frugal, but not foolish.
Right. He's not foolish.
No.
And maybe that's not the right word to even use at that point.
He already saved Northfield money, and he wasn't even a selectman.
I know he did.
He did it.
I know he did.
Okay, I have several things, but what do you have?
Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No,
you go first.
I don't have anything.
Oh, you don't have
anything? Go anyway, do it!
That was pretty good.
No, you go. I'm not saying a word.
Oh, you go. I'll go.
You go, Al.
No, go ahead. You go.
Somebody go.
I like that.
What do you want me to say?
Anything, whatever.
That was fun.
That was great.
I'm not saying nothing.
Saturday, May 4th is Seniors Helping Seniors for the Tilton School. So we have a list of the seniors that they will be going out and helping out, help spruce up their lawns for the spring.
Do they include disabled people?
Yes.
Is it publicized that way, or is it Seniors Helping Seniors?
Seniors Helping Seniors.
So it isn't publicized that way?
No.
That's too bad.
We could include that. I attended the budget committee last night, which was fairly interesting, but they have John Scanlon is the chairman, right. Again, and Wayne is the vice chair. PD will be visited. The next meeting is May 8th at the PD.
At the PD?
At the PD, in which they will take a current, they'll take a tour. There's two new people on the budget committee, one of it which is very familiar with police standards and training, as he is taught there. They would like a current project list and a past list of the completed projects, i.e., you know, your what you had done with your downstairs, and is there any other anticipated projects? The other question was the motorcycle. Will we be getting another motorcycle this year? That was another question from the budget committee. July, they are taking the month off, and highway will be the August meeting. They spoke about not having copies of the budget of the financials made each month for them, as they it's only cost to recycle, so they all have tablets. There's two, I guess, that requested copies, and so Johanna will get that information to you, but the majority of the board would really like it emailed to them.
Right.
So we included you as a paper copy, Catherine.
Thank you.
Last night also, we attended, Sandy and I attended the Fire Commissioner's meeting, and the letter that we sent. Do you remember the letter we sent to the Sanbiton Selectmen responding to their letter?
Mm-hmm.
And Joe Jessamine offering to be the representative from our board. Well, last month they read the letter. Tom Gallant read the letter from both the Sanbiton Selectmen and the Tilton Selectmen. And Pat Clark was vehemently trying to make a point that it should be the Belmont Selectmen, Belmont Fire, Sanbiton Selectmen, Sanbiton Fire. But when it comes to Tilton, it should be the Tilton Northfield Fire District as the governing body representing it. So, that being said, last night when they went over the minutes at the very beginning of the meeting, again, he wanted to clarify during the discussion on approving the minutes that he again wanted to say that the Tilton Northfield Fire Department should be the governing body representing the interests of Tilton and Northfield. I somewhat feel differently about that, because this is the Board of Selectmen. We are the ones that are responsible for the taxpayers in the town of Tilton, and that if there are decisions being based on the town of Tilton, we should know what they are being done. And if there are other selectmen there, then we should be privy to that knowledge.
Right.
So
I would still go to the meetings.
I feel strongly that we should write a letter to the commissioners and say that we object to that exclusion, and that based on us being responsible for the taxpayers of the town of Tilton, if there are any
The town of Tilton supported the Winnisquam Fire Department for many years before the district did, because we recognized the need for that service to the town of Tilton and that end of town.
Right.
The same applies now. We have, you know, brought it up before the fire commissioners for years that it is an exposed area of town. And it would be, a great, I don't know which word to use, it's a nice word. We should consider the needs of the citizens of the town of Tilton in East Tilton.
That's correct.
As the appointed representative, I personally feel that Mr. Clark has a point with regard to fire service. We don't have a fire department.
But we could.
Per se. Wait a minute, let me finish. However, I happen to agree with Pat and Catherine that you don't need a fire service to financially support a Winnisquam Fire Department.
Right.
Okay, and I don't think that our decision in any way reflected any slight to the fire commission. They should be involved in that conversation.
Particularly when selectmen from Sanbiton and Belmont are involved in the discussions and input is being taken from them that's going to impact them as well.
Well, they're their own fire commissioners, kind of. I mean, they have fire departments. They make that choice for the fire departments. We don't make this choice for the fire department, but we can still make a move to get them money as the town of Tilton to help to support the fire department. I mean, I would like to think that the fire commission would be all about exploring their options. And I got to believe they are. But I don't think that should preclude the Tilton selectmen from, or the town of Tilton, I should say, from being there, having input, and doing what's best for the residents of East Tilton.
Right.
The fire commissioners, regardless of what town they are from, their responsibility is to the needs of the fire district as a whole. And they very well could determine that having a fire station in Winnisquam does not meet the needs of the district as a whole, because it would only really serve the East Tilton area. However, the Board of Selectmen in Tilton certainly should be responsible for the needs of the citizens of the town of Tilton.
Absolutely. I don't think that our move to appoint a representative to that meeting has anything to do with trying to preempt the fire commissioners. I would not do that, and I would not vote in favor.
And I think that's what should be in the letter.
That's what I think should be in the letter, that it, we in no way want to do that, but we really should be we will be a part of
a conversation about East Tilton's public safety.
Right.
That's right.
So that being said, also one of their agenda items was goals and objectives for the upcoming year, and there was quite a bit of discussion on facilities and what to do at, you know, Center Street, go to Park, and leave Center Street alone, and, you know, so on and so forth. And there was quite a bit of discussion, and they talked about the committee that they had prior, and there's been no talk with it. It was two selectmen, one from each town, and the commissioners on the facility, which Sandy was part of. And then Tom looked up into the audience and asked Kevin if he would mind. They want to set up a meeting next week to start the conversation up again about facilities and goals and objectives to that. Would he mind attending? And then he asked me if I would mind, and I said, I'll ask either Sandy or, and then Pat said, well, what about Joe? But Sandy's been on the facilities committee, so I'm putting that out.
Oh, yeah, if you're willing to do it, you should, you know the answer.
I'm putting it out there, somebody should go on Wednesday at 6:00 PM, so.
Maybe I'll go with you and just sit there as a fact-finding thing, that might help the meeting up there.
And where's the meeting at?
That's to be determined, whether or not they can get Northfield or Tilton. Did they call today and ask for space for here, Catherine?
Didn't Catherine come in yesterday?
Catherine came in today.
Did Kathy call?
Kathy from the Pisces.
Tobin?
You're talking about Wednesday, yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
All right, it is here.
Then she emailed me again and changed it to 6. It's on the town calendar.
It's at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, I put it on the town calendar.
Okay.
All right. So they're having several meetings on that.
I still have my big pile of papers.
Different facilities, right.
Thank you for doing that, Sandy.
That's at 6 o'clock?
Yep.
I remember it was a little frustrating the last time.
The week after that is going to be on their personnel policy, so they've got a little committee going on that, for that, to get that going as well, so it looks like they're going forward. We have two new community service people. We don't have the other one?
Right, just one.
Just one, okay. One, and so Catherine wants him at the Riverfront Park for a few, if he can do it, and then Chief needs him, it's mandatory for at least 4 hours, but we need to, it's what we forgot to tell him yesterday.
We told him today.
Oh, we did?
Yep.
He's not going to like what I've got for him to do.
He loves it.
Like groundwork.
He loves anything, let me tell you.
He's been out here sweeping.
Oh, good. Yeah, I know, he's sweeping up. I'm not even going to go there.
So that's in the making. Oh, yeah, go ahead, what did I forget?
Joyce, last night, the budget committee did look at the schedule of classes.
Yeah, Joanna gave you the list.
Did she give it? Okay, I just wanted to make sure.
Two of them are going to attend, three of them.
Right.
Going to go to one as well, so.
Yeah.
And they gave me the list of two of them.
Yeah, you and me both.
Electronic copies.
Right.
And then Catherine's ordering a hard copy.
Right.
Of the budget, basic budget book.
But I was going to say.
Can't write on the screen.
Because Tim put those on our drives, doesn't he have an electronic copy? He could just send it to the budget members that.
And I look for one too, because I keep.
I don't think we have them on our drives.
No?
I thought he put them on our drives, but I don't think he had, I don't think he did.
I haven't seen them.
Okay.
I think he.
Right, do any of you, I mean, I remember I had a copy, and I kept it with the road book.
Yep.
Which used to be here, now that's gone.
No, the road book's over there.
Okay, over there.
We have municipal officials, directors.
I have referred to it a couple times, so I've just left it out on that table.
Yeah, because I remember I had it together, because the last time I was looking was on road stuff. And so I said, oh, it's with the road book.
I wonder if it's in there, because the road book was over there.
I looked in there, I looked all over here, I looked in my office, I looked everywhere.
I would like it on the thrive.
Me too.
On the thrive, okay.
Because we don't have it.
Don't put it on mine.
Okay, get it, you want to.
Be a waste of space.
Okay, I need mine transmitted electronically, I don't use the thrive.
But I'm glad that some of them are taking advantage of the workshops, because they're great workshops.
Yep.
I haven't seen the list.
Well, we told them that, you know, we explained, I've been to two of the budget workshops, and, you know, especially for the new people, they're fantastic, because.
Do you have the pamphlet of that? The budget pamphlet? I know the new one, the selectman one is on, in our folders, but not the budget. There may be some selectmen that would like to go. I saw it last night.
I have the choice, in fact, one year Catherine and I went together.
Six, I've got six electronic versions.
Yeah.
And one hard, and you won't want one for your drives.
Oh, you don't have to.
You're on this list, for the baseball.
I have the right to know.
I've been to it.
No, the book.
The book.
Oh, put me on the list.
Pass that down to Joe to sign.
No, I want all the copies.
She wants it electronically, Joyce.
Do we have the bill stuff?
No, we do not.
Not yet.
Mm-mm.
He didn't bring anything up.
Really?
Do we have a manifest or no?
No, remember he said there were no accounts payable for tonight?
Right.
He was right out straight.
He was rewriting the contract.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I'm finished, so.
I'm finished.
I have a list.
Okay.
Okay. Where's my stuff? Where's my stuff?
You see that?
I'm still playing catch-up. It came to my attention that we paid out abatement refunds when the taxpayer still owed us back taxes. And I was curious as to how and why that happened. And I think it happened on more than one occasion.
The procedure is once the selectmen have approved a disposition of abatement form, I give them to Catherine. Catherine goes to Cindy. Cindy's supposed to print out statements of all the taxes were owed on all their properties. On one of them, when it came back, there was only for the one property. So the other property, there were taxes due. So I think it was like $98 of the refund. It was not applied to the one that was owed, but you didn't receive that information.
So if we changed it so that before the abatement comes to us for signatures, that we have the tax cards, which tell you...
You do have them.
Whether there's one or two, plus the tax statements for both of the properties, or three of the properties, or whatever property they have.
When you print them, when you add the name, it should print out all the properties.
But when we get the packet, some of the abatements are very incomplete. I've complained about them for years. Some of them have a lot, some of them are just a page. That abatement should have all of that there.
And it does, Catherine. When you get the abatements, you get the cover letter from Lauren.
We don't get a...
The letter that Lauren has written for each abatement is attached to it.
I just looked through them, and some of them do not have that. Some of them...
Some of them are just a form.
Some of them just come with a form. Some of them do not have anything on there, any statement from Cindy, no tax cards. Some of them just come with a form. But regardless, in the future, we all need to be aware when those abatements come before us, we should not even be signing them till we're absolutely certain that the taxes are paid in full on any properties that the taxpayers own. And if the information is not there, they should not be signed.
You know, all this time I've been assuming by the time it got to us that it had already been checked. That's the only reason I signed them. It came to us. Lauren checked them. They've been
well,
checked.
You know, we're a very busy town hall, and we all can make mistakes. Yeah, I mean,
true enough.
So I think this is a way that will
correct it.
Correct it. Good. That there won't be any
good
any problems.
I think that's great. I assumed it was a done deal.
So what are you actually proposing from Joyce to get to us?
When an abatement application comes before us, be absolutely certain that it contains, I want to see the tax cards on it, because that's going to tell me how many properties that person may own, even if it's R.J. Moreau.
Oh, wow.
He wants copies of 72 cards.
No, one card that shows they have 72 pieces of property.
That's all separate parts.
Everyone's separate.
That's a very confusing one.
I just threw that out there because I know how many properties they own. But, you know, an individual taxpayer, all right, like myself, I have, God, I don't know
more
how many parcels.
One.
I have more than one parcel in town. So if I should apply for abatement, I would expect to see on mine the tax cards that go with that, that I have property in town.
Yeah.
I say, oh, okay, Dawson owns that property, that property, and that property, and that property, and that property. And then I would expect to see a report from Cindy for that.
Okay, if I could say, all right, that in the past, when I would go to the tax collector, because the selectman approved the abatement, okay? All the tax collector does is the selectmen give the tax collector a warrant. The warrant says, you go collect this amount of money.
Mm-hmm.
So all she's concerned about is, I'm told to collect this amount, I got to go collect it. If it's not collected, the only way, she's got to do a report saying, well, I didn't collect this, this person didn't pay. Or if the selectmen are abating based on assessment, then she has to go into her records and say, okay, I don't have to collect this money anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So in the past, before we process an abatement,
mm-hmm.
first of all, the selectmen, you know, they approve it, is we go to the tax collector and they say, does this person owe any property taxes? And tell me if they are paid, I need to know the date they paid. I would get back a little scrap of paper saying they don't owe anything. I said, no, I need the whole report. Because if they have paid, I need the date that they paid.
Exactly.
So I can calculate interest. So the procedure we have worked out, I thought, has worked very well. That they go to Catherine. No one should hand me a piece of paper when I'm in motion.
Me neither.
Catherine goes to Cindy. Cindy print me out the tax statements. I get the tax statements. I sit down, take that information. I have a spreadsheet so I can calculate the interest and what's due. Now on the RJ I knew ahead of time, I said, whoa, this one is very confusing because it's a lot of parcels. And I went to Cindy and I said, how do you want this? It's a lot. I'm not giving you 77 separate pieces of paper. She goes, okay, just break them down and do them individually on the sheet, which I did. I went through and I checked off each one. Okay.
Jesus.
One of them he had paid. I made a mistake. On that one parcel. There were 77 parcels. And I'm thinking in terms of, okay, all right, she wants these all separate. So I did them all and checked them off. I should have taken that one amount that they had paid and said, okay, no, this is a refund, but apply it to these. Break it out any way you want on these other 77 parcels. So that was the one mistake. But I think that the procedure that we have now is fine. It works fine. I can give you as much information as you want. I mean, right now I'm just getting the recommendation from Lauren. Lauren prepares the disposition of abatement form. I used to do that, but she does that now. She signs the form, and then the board makes a decision. If there's a refund, then we go and calculate the refund. But we try as best we can to get all the tax statements printed. But oftentimes on Thursday, we don't get them until late. And if there's refunds, I want to give them to the selectmen so they can review and approve. And then we go and get the tax statements when it's convenient.
Are the refunds applied to property taxes that are owed on other properties?
The law says that you can. If they have outstanding taxes and if they have not paid, then you can take the abatement or even if they have a refund. If they have other taxes outstanding, you can apply their refund.
What's our current policy?
Pardon me?
What's our current policy?
That's what we do.
That's what we do.
Okay.
That's what we do.
Well, because it's getting applied to the outstanding balance.
No, is it two that didn't get done that way? Or one?
Is it what?
Is it two that didn't get done that way, or is it just one?
Two.
Is it two what?
Is it two that got done that way? Or they did not
just
get done
one.
That way?
Just one was done that way because I didn't have all the information. The other one, with the one that had 77 properties, he was received a refund check that should have been applied to the one parcel. But they're going to pay. I mean, it's not losing money.
Mm-hmm. I know.
This long a discussion.
So we'll just have to make sure that we get all the tax statements from the tax collector.
Mm-hmm. We still have.
I'll have it all calculated out prior to the selectmen signing the abatement form.
Thank you.
That sounds great. Vespocket Park is still in the hands of the selectmen to manage and maintain. Did the selectmen want to give that back to the park commissioners to maintain?
Have they budgeted for that? I know I discussed it with the...
Yeah, I mean, the cost isn't...
And it was probably coming. You should take it into account with your budget.
It is, but it's a small part of that budget because it's such a small park. But last year it got a little shabby and got confusing, and I didn't... Park commissioners would be glad to take it back, or...
They have plans to...
Just to maintain it, just to mow it and trim it. It doesn't take much to take care of that.
No, it's a pretty small park.
I don't have any...
I would make a motion that...
Exactly.
It wasn't...
Wasn't blown with the state.
Yeah, exactly.
I would make a motion that we transfer authority for maintenance over Vespocket Park to the Parks Commission.
Okay.
Do you know how much we budgeted? That was a second, Al?
Yep.
So a motion was made in a second to give the authority to maintain Vespocket Park to the Parks Commission, seconded by Al. The motion was by Joe. Do we know how much was budgeted for Vespocket Park to maintain it under the highway?
I want to say they were going to put away...
I can't imagine that he...
I think it was $800 or something.
I can't imagine he even...
No.
I
forget right offhand, but I was at that meeting and I took Catherine's place that night, is what it was.
I doubt it was $800.
And, well, that for some reason that sticks... But they took it into account.
Maybe that was both that and...
No, let's transfer that into the park commissioner's account.
The $800?
Well, we have to find out how much it's...
Not before Dennis comes back.
No, I think, you know, it's all selectmen's budget, so no matter where it is.
Yep. Okay, any more discussion on that? All those in favor of moving the responsibility to Vespocket Park to the Parks Commissions, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstain? Okay.
The park commissioners are getting estimates for the tree work. In the past, they've gotten estimates for those in the parks, as well as the island, the main street, and they'll do the Christmas tree. So those will be presented to the selectmen, the main street, Christmas tree, and the island for their purview and action.
Are they putting out RFPs this year for landscaping? I've gotten a couple calls.
No, the contract with Dolph was for 2 years.
And you're going to keep it?
And they met with him at the last meeting, worked it out, and he is going to hold that price for them.
Okay.
So they're going to go with him. The other question I'm going to bring up is a zero-turn radius lawnmower that the town owns. Currently, the park commissioners are looking at not a professional lawn tractor to do the park because they didn't budget thousands and thousands of dollars for that. So they're looking at a tractor as it was in their budget. It's really not an adequate piece of equipment to mow the ball field. It takes a long time. I don't think it'll last very long because it's not designed for that type of mowing.
Right.
So I'm back again to request that the zero-turn lawnmower that the town purchased specifically to mow the park and especially the ball field be relinquished to the park commissioners to be stored at the ball field, to be used at the ball field. It's not a lawnmower that the town garage uses. The only lawn they could possibly mow with it is at the town garage.
And they already have a mower to do that lawn.
They don't mow cemeteries with it. They can't. It literally is sitting there just...
Doing nothing.
Doing nothing.
Well, I thought when we asked before that he said he did use it.
Right, he did.
No, he said that they needed to be certified to operate it.
No, but when he was asked,
he said the maintenance.
He does use it, and he can't use it in the cemeteries, but he does use it.
Where?
He said he does use it.
Where?
We didn't ask where.
Well, then we need to ask where, because...
So let's have this conversation next week with Dennis.
I am having people come up to me, asking me, why is the park commissioners buying a lawnmower to mow the field, when we own a lawnmower to mow the field?
He'll be back from vacation, we can ask him.
He's back on Monday.
Yep.
I do believe, I really do believe that they need a lawnmower for, to do what they, what they do. I totally am behind you on that. I'm not opposed at all for them to get a lawnmower, but my understanding was you were going to get help to get a lawnmower from the Friends of Winnesquam Football.
Oh, they donated a lawnmower to us, but it, you know, it's an older, it's a residential tractor mower. It's pretty well worn out after being used this last season. They're just not designed for that kind of mowing. And again, they're small decks. I let them use my zero-turn radius, which is a commercial mower. It has three blades. And it's amazing, you know, like, zoop, zoop, zoop. It's designed for that. So I can tell you they're also, they're certified to use a zero-turn radius. I just find that ludicrous. But there's a huge difference. You can see the difference in the field when you use my mower as opposed to their little residential, you know, tractor. Just saying.
Oh, there is definitely a huge difference when you use a zero turn to a regular lawnmower. Even the weight of the tires on a regular tractor is different.
It's
dispersed different.
It's dispersed different. It's just, it's, you know.
Who would maintain?
Can we put this on the agenda for next
town
week?
Town garage. It's town
Dennis
property. It's a town mower.
But so ask them to come in at 3:30.
We're meeting at 3:30 next week.
Yep. Senator Forrester is going to be at the Tilton Senior Center on Affordable Care Act at 6:30.
That's the 18th.
Mm-hmm.
I would have been late. Last thing I have is, Chief, and this involves you, the yard sale. We're in that, coming to that season that's held at the intersection of Route 3 and Manville. The traffic problem there has never really fully been resolved. The distance that they can park to the intersection, and I did go down there and pull into Manville Road when that was going on and pull out, and they are right. You can't see if you want to turn. You're out into the traveled way because of the cars that are parked in the eastbound side. And then you've got cars on the westbound side, which leaves you this very narrow place to actually pull out. I mean, you're pulling into oncoming traffic almost, because you're both trying to share a single-lane highway now because it's been reduced by the cars parked on the...
You're basically parking in the street.
Yeah.
I've run into that myself.
We need to address that. We have to have a resolution before there is a tragedy there.
No parking on that side of the street.
Got to be something. I don't know what we can do.
Oh, that's the road.
If they want to park on the lawn, maybe that's his property. He still can't obstruct the sight line.
It's dangerous.
What's the date of that?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just...
It's ongoing all summer.
Yeah.
It's an ongoing Saturday, Sunday... They just put things out, and it's ongoing.
So before they start yard sailing there, I think we need to come to... Actually, I don't know why I'm saying you, because it's going to have... it's going to have to be you.
Okay.
I'm sorry, but we do need to have a resolution to that.
April 27th is a townwide yard sale, and they... I don't know if they're signed up for that or not, but potentially April 27th would be the first day that would come into effect.
That's all I have.
April 27th?
That's right. It's a Saturday. Yard sale begins at 8 a.m.
That's it.
Okay. Al, do you have anything?
I'm good for the week.
Al, do we have any resolution to the store putting in their post and getting rid of the sawhorses?
I'll call them on Monday.
I noticed that he painted the berm.
Mm-hmm.
But we don't know when the posts and the signs are going in.
I think he said he's looking for a resolution about the parking. I don't know why.
What parking?
The three spaces in front.
I think that's fairly resolved.
I thought it was.
We can take our sawhorses down anytime.
No, we can't, not until he has the post there to protect it.
The posts were part of it, that's why he put up the sawhorses.
That was the part of the agreement.
Yeah.
He was supposed to...
He likes the ugly sawhorses.
He was supposed to put the post in the berm so that cars don't pass over there and damage the vehicles. But the parking in the front has absolutely no ties to this agreement whatsoever, none. And he was quite aware of that at the meeting.
I will call him on Monday.
Thank you. Okay, Joe?
I have a couple of things.
Okay.
Motion to adjourn.
Gee, too bad.
Second.
No. Last night, I wasn't at the Budget Committee, as you know, because I was at the Tilt Northfield Old Home Day. Old Home Day Committee. The Old Home Day this year will be on June 22nd. The theme is Wizard of Oz.
Nice.
Yep. Jane, you might want to be in touch with Peg Shepherd because you were assigned any number of different money collection duties. As far as the citizen of the year goes, there are a couple names floating out there right now, which I will not name at this time. But that'll be finalized at the meeting next week. So
I'm fine with those names.
I told you what the names were.
Right.
Okay.
I'm fine with those. We can make a motion if everybody's okay
with
it.
Well, no, not in public. They want to keep this under wraps for.
We don't have to mention the name.
Make a motion to accept the
recommendations.
Recommendation.
Two people recommended by the Old Home Day Committee for.
I'll second that.
Right.
Citizens of the year.
Yep.
Right. Motion's been made and seconded.
Know who we're talking about.
Okay. All those in favor?
Yes.
Aye.
Yes.
Yes. Opposed?
Okay. That's basically the Old Home Day preparations are just.
One opposed.
Really?
Yep.
No, okay. I didn't oppose.
Did you? I thought you said opposed.
No.
All right, all in favor?
Say, wait till I tell them.
If nothing, I might abstain because I don't even know these people. But
okay.
Well, trust me, there.
Oh, I have no doubt. I have no doubt.
So, it's unanimous. We'll give you the names afterwards. Thank you.
First, let me say, and this is not it, but if you haven't read the consortium agreement, the MetroCast renewal franchise agreement, and started to make your transmit it electronically. Anybody who doesn't have it, let me know, because we're starting to get short on that. Please read it and make your notations. Went to a co-op meeting.
The consortium? Wait a minute.
Consortium. All right, now we're going to ease into co-op.
No, wait a minute. The consortium, you sent out the...
A couple weeks ago.
Yep, I did.
A draft contract.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But the consortium is going to vote on this contract. If there's something you would like to change or whatever, start thinking about it, because we're not held to the template. I will have our appendixes, our buildings, our stuff will be inserted in there, certainly, but you guys need to start, because the contract ends at the end of the year, clock is running, and it gets, can't wait until December 20th to do this.
Right.
Okay. Now, I handed you a draft agreement. I went to a cooperative meeting. That's Concord Regional Solid Waste Resource and Recovery Cooperative. As you know, the cooperative agreement ends on December 31st of 2014. That's 18 months, but it's not, because the Wheelabrator, who is also waste management that runs the incinerator, and who the co-op, which we are a member of, has a contract with for our tipping fees and what have you, wants an answer by the end of June on extension of the, yeah, really, on the end of the contract. We're trying to, that's going to be problematic all over the place. We're trying to get an extension of that, but this draft agreement has, God, I sat through a four-hour meeting getting this packet explained to me. I'm not going to go there, but the highlights are...
Thank you.
If you go to page two, all right, you'll see existing contract. This is all public information.
Right.
All right. Existing contract 2013 and 14.
Mm-hmm.
All right. This is what happens if we continue just the way we are right now.
Okay.
If we sign up by June 30th for the new contract, which would extend us to 2022, okay, then the second thing kicks in. Now you'll see an ash credit. Okay, the tipping fee at the Wheeler Breeder is going up to $64 a ton.
Oh.
But they're giving us a credit of $17 a ton for all of the ash from all of their sources that they're bringing there, not just the co-ops, because they're dumping ash in Franklin. They want to fill up the Franklin landfill before they close it at the end of 2014. At the end of 2014, the co-op dissolves as we know it. The ash landfill will be closed. The monies that we have accrued over time, and there are dedicated funds, 10-year, 50-year, 100-year funds for the monitoring of the leachate. There's some kind of a, not barium, but some kind of a radioactive substance leaking out from underneath that thing. And we have a number of wells. We have very expensive equipment that cleans this before it goes to the waste treatment plant. And we have to monitor those and test them and put stuff in them. And it's quite an impressive thing. But you'll notice that the administrative cost, because the landfill is still open, would continue at $6 a ton. Now, we're paying $11 a ton to the co-op. I couldn't get a straight answer where the other $5 was. I don't know. Total project cost, you'll see, $88 a ton. Except for, I was told that the real cost was $110 a ton. Again, they're going to have to go back and redo these figures. There's a number of discrepancies, and we'll run across those as we go. The subsidy that we're currently paying, according to this, is $21 a ton. And as I was not at that meeting, that came on a night where Dennis went, I don't know for a fact that that's incorrect, but in any case, that's what happens under the new contract in column two. If we sign on, all right, after 2014, which would be new territory, all right, they would hold the contract price at $64 a ton first year, but you'll see the administrative costs go down to $2 a ton. That's because we don't have to have R.J. Edmonds or R.C. Edmonds or whatever with his equipment there. They move the ash around, they put the cover on, and those kind of things.
Isn't it on his property?
No, the co-op owns that property.
Where the ash is being dumped?
That's right.
Oh, I thought he owned that.
He owns the property in front of that. All right. Now, contract credit back to communities. I didn't get a satisfactory answer to exactly what that was, quite frankly. I didn't get a satisfactory answer. That I could understand anyway. Like I say, 4 hours worth of legal information. And I told the lawyer I hated him. The chairman says, well, don't hold anything back. It's like, oh no, I'm well known for hating lawyers. So they're proposing that the from 2015 to 2022, accepting the rate of inflation, because in this proposal there is a rate of inflation cost built into it. They're saying that the tipping fee would be $66 a ton, and that there would be no use of the shortfall or reserves. Go on to the next page. Don't ask me questions. Listen to the presentation and think about it, because there's a lot to digest here. All right. You'll see that I made some notes. You got copies of my notes. Okay. So if there's two options, you don't enter into the contract. We pay $66.80 a ton through the end of 2014. And then we're on our own thereafter. Or we enter into the contract. Now, in order for the contract to take effect, 58.5% of co-op waste has to be going into the incinerator. And just bear that number in mind. But if Concord enters the agreement, 75% of the waste has to go, or the contract terms are off. Let's keep on going. You'll go on down and you'll see prorate this amount over there beside Tilton, $117,000. Regardless of whether or not we enter into a contract, we will receive as our share of the assets $117,000. Now, we could take that back as a credit against our tipping fees or whatever. All right, next page. The terms of the agreement, I won't go through this every little bit. It does say in under retention of waste that about the 75% from Concord. After we have a $600,000 payment to Wheelabrator to offset taxes that's in the current amount or current account because the assessment flew through the roof from Concord. They're the ones. It actually sits in Concord, although the land does, even though Penacook is where it's classically referred to. Concord owns that property, or they claim that property as Concord territory. I suggest that you read the fine print as we go along. You're going to get a chance to look at this. I'm not asking for any kind of action. That would be dangerous. There is a provision in here for Facility 1 and Facility 2 membership in the co-op. We can elect to dissolve our relationship with the co-op at the end of 2014. If we do that, we get back a share of the assets, excluding those amounts that are in specifically dedicated amounts for the closure of the landfill, the monitoring of the wells, and the capping of the top of this thing, and the replanting and seeding, and all the rest of the things that go with that. Those monies are dedicated. There's a statement in the very back of this. You'll notice this is the range of asset distributions down at the bottom goes from $6.5 million high to $4.8 million low. It's got the criteria on that, but that's the bottom line. We've got $12 million in the reserves, but we have a certain amount of money that out of that amount that has to go toward the landfill closing. Personally, I was, this was convoluted. I think that Belmont, certainly, Jeannie Bowden, who is the town administrator in Belmont, explained about the Best Way facility on Route 140, and they're trying to put a transfer station there. the permitting has been applied for and what have you, and it would be down the road, certainly, but Belmont's committed through the end of 2014, and they're looking for, to make a sweetheart deal with Bestway. Mr. St. Hilaire, at his meeting with us several weeks ago, did say something about should we try to get out of the, or should we decide to end our bringing trash to Wheelabrator, that they would love to give us a price, and he felt that they could do better. Now, what they were going to do with the garbage at that point, I don't know. Are they going to bring it to Bethlehem and bury it up there, which I think is known as Carberry? That's the name, and that's a consortium of towns. They own the waste facility up there. And it's called Berlin, or people say, oh, yeah, we're going to ship it to Berlin. I don't think it's technically in Berlin. It's just outside Berlin. It's a number of towns, I guess, that operate this jointly. But that's a finite thing. I mean, they can't continue to bury garbage there forever.
Didn't he also say to us that with Casella, that they already own a place up there, that would
they own one in Vermont for a fact?
Yeah.
What our transportation costs would be?
I thought he said northern New Hampshire.
Yeah,
that might be. I don't know one way or the other. I missed that. I thought he had one in Vermont, but
well, he
did.
Aren't they from Maine?
They're from Vermont.
Right, they did say Vermont.
I thought they were from Maine.
No, Casella's from Vermont.
New York?
No, they're all over the place.
He had some in New York, Vermont, northern New Hampshire.
Yeah. But quite frankly, when they give us a price for the tipping fees and what they'll take our garbage away for per ton, that'll be it. How they get it to wherever they bring it is on them.
Yeah.
So,
you know, so that they'll have to figure that into
their bid. We really have a truly, I mean, this is mind-boggling to me.
Oh, God, yes.
When I can't even imagine going through a four-hour meeting on this and following this right from the
Those beginning. Are just the highlights, but the minute details of this, I'll be glad to sit there and answer your questions one by one.
So essentially, we really have to figure out whether it's best to discontinue Concord and go with perhaps maybe making a deal with Wheelabrator, maybe with the Bestway people, or is it better to stay with them? I mean, there's some huge decisions, particularly after we voted with pay as you throw. I mean, there's some big.
Our tonnage is going to go down. There's more stuff coming. I've got more information in this pile to give you on that. But
right.
Our tonnage is going to go down.
Well, I'm looking at page 6 of this. It talks about proposal includes liquidated damages in the amount of $15 per ton if a participating municipality were to intentionally divert waste from their control.
Right.
That's the Allenstown clause.
Right.
This liquidated damages payment would apply to diverted tonnage under the municipality's control based on the most recent 12 months tonnages of waste prior to the date of determination. So here we're going to pay as you throw.
And
we want to reduce our tonnage.
Let me explain what that's about. Allentown a couple years ago decided because they I don't know if it's Casella, I don't have any clue who owns that transfer station, but they have a transfer station there. And don't think of transfer station in terms of the Tilton transfer station. This is a garbage place where they take all the garbage from several municipalities and then ship it somewhere else.
And this is where?
Allentown. I know
in
the history.
Town of Allentown. Allenstown was getting a sweetheart deal. I believe they were allowed to dump their garbage at no cost to them. I believe.
Okay.
It was much less money as far as getting their tipping fees and whatever. And of course, there was no transportation because it was in Allenstown, basically. So their hauling was cheaper. How did they get out of the contract they signed with the co-op? There was nothing in there to account for it. So there were lawyers, and you know how I love lawyers, but nonetheless, it was a long, protracted fight. It cost the co-op money, which means it cost us money to defend the co-op's position. Allentown forfeited a lot of money to do this. What that clause right there on page 6 does is to set forth a penalty for withdrawal. If you're going to withdraw, this is how much the withdrawal will cost you. All right? Now, if you go to the very last page, I think it's the last page. Where is that?
21?
It's not the last page. What number is it?
20?
Yeah.
20, 19?
All right. Holland did estimated differences. Yeah, all right. It's this one that says Berlin down in the corner where it says Carberry or whatever. I don't know. I can't see a page number on here.
Down in the bottom?
It looks like page 16.
Okay, it's towards the back.
16.
There
Berlin in his writing on it.
It says Berlin on the lower left-hand corner.
Okay, page 16.
If you go to the top of that and you... This is the estimated differential costs of whether you get involved in the co-op or not. First off, there's two levels of co-op. We can choose not to join the co-op. We can join the co-op and bring our trash somewhere else. Or we can join the co-op and extend our contract with Wheelabrator and dedicate our tonnage to the incinerator through 2022.
Why would we want to join the co-op and not...
Let me tell you why. Because we're going to be paying our share of the asset... currently in place.
Yeah.
No matter what, we have to. We're liable for that in our contract. Mm-hmm. The landfill closure costs and stuff like that. If we get out of the co-op, we'll get. And there's a list in here of what we would get, and it's in the high six figures, I think. No, those are the fee projections. That we would get money, but that's based on our ownership of the real estate assets as well. There's two sections of real estate, one beside the incinerator in Pennacook / Concord, and one in Canterbury, where they at one time were thinking about making a landfill, which fell by the way, but they own that. And I think that, I want to say, $1.5 million worth of real estate. We walk away from that. We get money, but we're going to walk away from that. By staying in, we have no obligation necessarily, but we do have a vote in the dispensation of those assets. And we do have a vote with regard to how the money is spent for the closing costs. We have no vote if we walk away at the end of 2014. We'll get money, and not that that money would go away anyway. That money will be dispersed because that's the excess reserves. All right, but we have no say in the future of the co-op, even though we have responsibility for the future of the co-op assets, whether it be the landfill or the two properties that are undeveloped right now. So we could take our garbage anywhere we wanted, certainly. We'd have no administrative fee because, quite frankly, we have no garbage to contend with. We have no tonnage, but we would still have a vote at the table on any matter that was in relationship to those properties and that landfill. And seeing as we have to have a responsibility for that landfill, I think we should have a vote for the landfill. Even if we decide not to continue with dumping garbage through the co-op at the incinerator. Something to take into account.
So when are they, when do we need the decision?
June 30th.
Oof.
We've asked for an extension because, quite frankly, Belmont can't get it together by then. Warner can't get it together by then. Franklin can't get it together by then. Laconia can't get it together by then. And
is Sanbiton part of that or no?
No. And I'm guessing they have their own dump. I'm guessing that Concord can't either. somebody said, oh yeah, but there's only 24 votes involved. That shouldn't take that long. I said, no, there isn't. There's more like 150. I said, there's 15 councilors and the mayor in Concord. There's 5 selectmen in Tilton. That's 30 people in 2 communities. Now, how many are there all together? And you expect everybody to make a decision by June 30th? That doesn't make sense to me.
I thought Concord backed out.
They backed out of committing their recycled tonnage to the single-stream facility.
Everything.
The issue of the future of the co-op is a separate thing.
Okay.
I have information about that, but that's coming too. You'll see here on the page that...
I think in the future, Joe, I think we need to put you at the first of the meeting and allot some...
You started at that end, okie dokie.
I know, I'm regretting it, but...
I haven't gotten to the recycle part yet.
I know you do. Either that or we have a special meeting because there's so much going on right now with recycling and the co-op and the consortium, and you're carrying the load... that we really need to allot that time to you to do that. So my apologies to you.
We can set that up. You can dedicate a meeting to me or a special meeting or whatever you want to do, and I will be glad to do it then. But this stuff pretty much has to be said tonight.
Yeah.
Right now, anyway.
Right.
Okay, so if you go to that Berlin page, you'll see a disposal option if we were to bring it, for instance, to Mount Carberry. Okay, which is the Berlin location. And if you go down three more? Where is it? There's one very interesting one here. Okay, page 21. This is because I'm thinking to myself, there's no way we're going to do better than to withdraw from this, because this sounds silly to me. I'm sitting there going, no, I can't vote for this. How can I bring this back and sell it to selectmen? This is silly. Then you get to the back, and it's got the various cooperative towns on there. If we go with the Wheeler-Brader contract, basically as written, and Concord gets in, or we have the proper percentages to key this all in, it would cost us $697,000.
To throw away trash.
It's going to cost us damn near that, no matter what we do.
What happens if we don't get the proper percentage
of... That's over those years.
How many years?
This is over 7 years or whatever.
Yeah,
over 7. Okay. Whatever, through 2022.
Still 7 years. I mean, we that's a whole life safety complex right there.
Oh, God, don't say life safety complex. Town meeting, I want a town meeting. Okay, go out a couple of there, and it says best way. The NCES, I believe that's a potential, and but that's back on 16, the Berlin page.
Are these best way as we know it today, or are these factual, or do we, if we talked with best way, would they be different?
Checking. This is on the published numbers that they
Okay, gotcha.
Currently.
All right.
We might make a better deal.
So the negotiating...
We might negotiate better.
Okay.
But as you can see, under the WCC Wheeler-Brader contract, we spent almost $698,000 over that time period. Best way, we spend $783,196. Okay? Which means that best way would be 12.2% higher for a net savings to us, according to these figures, at $85,200 over the course of the 2022 contract.
All of this is based on our current tonnage before pages.
And it's based on projection.
That's the numbers that they have. These are the numbers that they have. So this is a potential thing. This is not written in stone. This is like, think about this and look at this and how does this work for us? And we have to decide by June 30th. It's ludicrous. And every town on this list has to do that.
Because then you throw
throw in, no pun intended, but then you throw in pay-as-you-throw, and...
Our tonnage goes down.
Our tonnage goes down.
We get penalized
numbers,
for it.
These numbers change drastically.
Theoretically.
Well, that 58%, 75% is of the municipal solid waste that goes to trash.
But we don't want... so.
Not necessarily. That would be... The 75% of our garbage, or of the total garbage. Now, our total garbage is going to be whatever it is. But if we commit, that would be 75. They have to have 75% of the members sign up for this and dedicate their trash to the incinerator.
So
that's what Wheelabrator is looking for, is a source for their garbage, because the incinerator doesn't go without garbage.
Are you saying, then... pay-as-you-throw is going to lower our tonnage.
Oh, yes.
Yet, we're going to be charged, theoretically, for lowering our tonnage with Wheelabrator Fry down on that end, so pay-as-you-throw is actually going to cost us money.
No, no. This is,
how you figure that?
These numbers are figured at 1,391 tons. They had to pick a number, and that was the last number they had. Our tonnage is going down, so either one of these numbers will go down by 30, 35, 40%. But it will go down in both columns.
But what if they go down? It says in here if they go down, we're theoretically going to get charged.
No, 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 no.
Exactly what it says.
If we withdraw, we get charged $15 a ton for the life of the whatever is left of the contract.
No, it's not what it says.
What page?
Page 6. If a participating municipality were to intentionally divert waste within their control.
Well, read that. Read
I did
that.
Read that.
That means that if we commit to the incinerator and then decide to bring it to Berlin, we've diverted waste under our control.
How
that's
can we commit?
That's not what
how
it says.
How can we commit right now when we very well know that we passed a warrant that says we're going to pay as you throw, which is going to lower it. We don't have no figures to what that is, how much it's going to lower the tonnage. How can we commit to that?
You're not getting page 6. The clause is in page 6.
Control would mean such waste that was delivered directly by the municipality from a municipally owned transfer station and or from a municipally operated curbside residential service and or from contractors providing curbside residential service directly on behalf of the municipality. That's
the
exactly what
ordinance.
It says.
The flow ordinance.
It's exactly
the Allenstown
what it
clause.
Says.
Just listen for a second. The Allenstown clause. Okay, they mm-hmm. took the garbage. We have a deal with them for 4,500 tons. That's our GMQ, right?
Yeah.
If all of a sudden we only delivered 2,000 tons because we ship our garbage somewhere else.
Yeah.
And that's what we're doing.
Right.
Go pay as you throw, single stream, the best way.
No, because that's taken out of our waste stream. That's no longer MSW. This is only about MSW.
What you are saying is not what this says.
That's exactly what it says.
So,
oh, no.
Municipal garbage under our control. The recyclables are not no more than the garbage that the Tanger outlet puts together. Recyclables are a commodity. They're not MSW.
Oh, it says here clearly, if we reduce our tonnage based on the most recent 12-month tonnage of waste prior to the date of determination, and we're going to reduce our waste
but what he's
by
saying
removing
is,
the recyclables.
That's
exactly what we're doing.
We're going
all
to
the trash
to
that I put out on the curbside I've been putting out for years is going to be reduced.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this says. It doesn't exempt pay-as-you-throw. It doesn't say if you send it to pay-as-you-throw. It says if we reduce our tonnage.
So have you ever asked that question?
Intentionally divert waste. Recyclables are not waste.
Oh,
it's a commodity.
Right now they are waste. And right now they've been calculated
but in
as
the,
waste.
But in the trash world, they're commodities.
Well,
they're
I don't care. This paragraph says what it says very clearly.
Do you realize that if we take 40% of our MSW tonnage, our GMQ, and we send it somewhere else. Okay, we're automatically hooking ourselves in to paying $11 a ton because that's what they base the fee on at the co-op for every ton of garbage we fall under the GMQ. We pay based on the GMQ.
Yeah.
If we, that's why it's so important to guess correctly, maybe even 100 tons less, because if we brought more to the incinerator, we pay the $11 on every ton we bring more. But if we bring less, we don't pay the tipping fee, but you still have to pay the $11. That's in the contract.
And we get
fined for
reducing.
Is there a decision that needs to be made on this tonight?
No.
Hell no.
Heavens no.
Hell no.
So
there are going to be, this is the very first draft. There's going to be other drafts following this. I insisted they go back through their numbers and make sure that they were all correct. There are glaring errors in the numbers, and I know there are, and I pointed them out. There will be other.
What I'm suggesting that, I'm suggesting two things. Mm-hmm. One is that 2 weeks, not next week, because next week's with Jeannie, Senator Forrester. But the week after that, I think we should allot some time specifically and not take an appointment, specifically to this.
The garbage.
The garbage.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Absolutely.
Well,
hopefully I'll have
and then specifically to recycling, specifically to the consortium, because we have to read that consortium contract, correct?
Yes.
So I we have... should spend a couple hours just on that.
Yes.
Period.
Yes.
Right.
I have given a copy of this. I just received it yesterday. I gave a copy of it to Tim this evening, and you might have heard my statement about a fine tooth comb. He's got the proper Tilton numbers that can be plugged into this, and he's going to be taking a look at that, and so we'll have a better idea about. But I got to tell you, my instantaneous reaction, despite my trying to explain some of these clauses, is that we find a place to dump the garbage.
Mm-hmm. Would the selectmen rather that, or pick another afternoon meeting so that we just specifically are here for
garbage,
recycling, and consortium?
I agree, because right now I am so tired. I'm
trying
tired so hard
too.
To concentrate on what you're saying.
Well, you don't need to concentrate a lot on the numbers or anything else I've said except for read this thing.
Well, I will read it, but...
That's the most important thing you can do on that subject for tonight. Read it. Make yourself as familiar as you can with, like I say, 4 hours of people trying to explain this. And I don't know if anybody walked away from that meeting thoroughly convinced they knew what was presented to them. A lot of the numbers were obviously wrong, but this is their first attempt.
Can we maybe get together one day next week and do nothing but talk garbage?
Like in the afternoon?
Talk trash?
Yes.
Talk trash.
Talker, yeah.
Hey, we're tilting trash anyway, so we might as well talk trash.
I'm all about that. You guys pick the time, and I'll...
I want to give you the time.
Wednesday is bad for me.
I'm exactly where you are right now.
I just can't comprehend. I'm too tired. You know?
Okay, well, we still have to... I should have... Well, no. We still have to go over this recycle stuff.
I'm okay with Tuesday afternoon. I'm okay with Wednesday afternoon.
Okay.
That's Tuesday the 16th.
Yeah.
There is, and have you all received the proposed recycle hauling contract agreement? There were a number of signatures I asked.
Can I get one that clearly spells out the changes from the motion and the vote that we took last week on it?
I don't know. I'm tired myself. I don't even
we
know.
We took a vote and a motion to...
You know, the vote was just to accept the contract with those rates of pay.
And we signed that contract.
We did.
Where is that
you
contract?
You signed a contract. Right, that was the one we discussed the other day, Kathy.
Correct.
Tim has
the contract that
one.
Tim put together.
So can we
get... at it. I looked at that. Well, it's been completely rewritten, if you look at the...
You
the
have... Question. It's not something we're going to sign tonight, I hope. It is something that needs to be studied.
Well, if you haven't read it already, then no, we're not going to sign it.
We didn't see it until tonight, Joe.
Now we're looking at July or August.
Joe,
I've looked at the contract that Tim wrote.
The new one?
When I read it, I found, we went over it together, and I found things, and he found things, and he has again changed it. I've gotten...
And didn't send me a copy?
I don't know what time he sent it to you. I've gotten a third draft, and I haven't read that one. I mean, I'm suggesting that we want to read this carefully.
Well, what about what we signed?
What we signed has no protection for us.
But I think it was lacking.
It has no performance clauses in it. It does not protect us. The new contract is very similar to our solid waste contract, and it has a lot of clauses that protect us. It has performance clauses, et cetera, et cetera.
So we
it's a much meatier, better contract.
Can someone scan the original one that we signed and motioned?
I don't know if I even have a copy of that one.
I have it right here.
Oh, okay.
I can go scan it.
I'm saying, can we email it? Then I can at least print it out or highlight it online, the differences, so I can read it.
You can highlight it online?
That one right there. Cool. Oh, yeah, that's easy. I'll show you how to do it.
This is the packet right here, and this is the contract that we signed.
Mm-hmm.
This is it right here. It's the very first page. And according to this, when we talked about it, that we are signing this together with everything that they had sent us that was represented.
But everything that they sent us isn't in what you signed.
Right.
Well, according to this, it says all terms, wait a minute.
It's not in there. It's not part of the document you signed. And one of the problems is when we sign these documents, you're not initialing every page.
Right.
Right. Well, then I would suggest, because my first reaction was
I don't have the new one, Sandy. I don't.
Here.
No. I just don't know the difference. Oh, wait. April 3rd. Wait a minute.
That was the one we signed.
April 3rd is when we signed. Well, what about the other one?
The new
Tim
one is right here. I've got it. Hang on.
I hope that microphone doesn't pick up.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Oh, good.
Hang on, I've got it.
Whispering sweet nothing.
Nope, but it's not in there.
We shouldn't be in such a hurry to go forward with this pay-as-you-throw and all of this and make mistakes along the way.
Well, there you go. I want to get this done as quickly as possible.
No, we want to get this done.
You're going to let me finish, Catherine?
Well, quickly as possible? That's
well, he hadn't finished his sentence.
I didn't finish my sentence.
Go ahead, finish your sentence. I'm
tired.
I want
to get this done as quickly as possible, but not at the expense of making a bad deal. I'm not an expert in contracts, and although I read the one that you guys signed, and it appeared fine to me after talking with Tim and Catherine, subsequently there were glaring omissions from that left us liable, that could have been bad for us. I don't want to make a bad deal. I want it to be the right deal, because at the end of next year, if we make the wrong deal, they're going to come back and they're going to say, this is stupid and it's not what you said, and they're going to change it.
So what if we get together Tuesday? Anybody have anything planned on Tuesday? Can
what
we get together
Tuesday?
On Tuesday afternoon? And
there goes our inspections.
Does that take care of your concern, Catherine, about what I was going to say?
Well, I think, no, it's a contradiction of what you said, but that's okay.
What do you want? What, Catherine, what, do you have anything? What do you say in
special? We can.
We can work around it, so tell us what time.
No, I mean, we have a lot of inspections to do. We're going to do next week, so.
3 o'clock, I have a commitment I can't break on Tuesday, so we have to do it early.
We have to be early.
So what if we did, like, 12:30.
We'll get the pizza and have a working lunch.
As early as possible, Tuesday would be great.
We could do it at noon.
Do
you want to do that?
Sure.
Yeah.
You want to do that? We'll get a pizza.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, what documents do you want for that meeting? We want what?
We want the
email today at 1:47.
Right.
Yep.
And we want the original. It's in the, no, it's in the
okay.
FYI.
All right, you want that scanned.
Yep.
Or copied, one or the other. I want to know the differences. I just want to, if he even takes the one he mailed today and highlight the differences or the whole thing's changed, then I'll read the whole thing.
Okay.
I haven't had a chance at 140 to look at it.
This is the one he emailed us late today.
That one, I asked him to make sure that the clauses were in there without reinventing the wheel. You're holding a reinvented wheel, so...
Yeah, it's only a couple, it's four pages. The other one is...
Well, he took out the referenced documents. The reference documents were ambiguous in several places.
Okay.
And it may or may not have covered us under certain contingencies. The document that, as I understand it, I'm not a lawyer, thank God, and I'm not as well versed as some in contracts.
I have a chance to see it.
But appears to cover most of those bases.
So we'll go over the, we'll allot, you know, a couple hours, we'll noon, a couple hours for the, that, keep, get us up to date on recycling and go over a little bit on the consortium. Is that okay? It's gonna be your day, that's your agenda.
I'm all over it.
Catherine, nothing else on the agenda except the garbage consortium and recycling.
We have received some quotes for bags.
We have. You wanna go into that or you wanna wait till Tuesday?
No, we wait till Tuesday and there's another one coming.
Yep. I spoke with Chip Chesley. This is the last, I'm gonna just cut it off after this. But I spoke with Chip Chesley.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna bob it. Well, that's where you were going anyway, Sandra. Fact is...
I'm to quit.
Chesley, no, you need to hear this part.
No, I didn't need to hear that.
Chip Chesley, okay. I apologize.
No, I don't.
No, you don't.
It wasn't
Chesley,
you.
Chip Chesley is Dennis Allen, but in Concord.
Okay. Yeah.
And he's got a lot more departments, but he's the guy. He's on the board of the co-op with me as well, and we sat for an hour after the co-op meeting and talked about Concord's effort at pay-as-you-throw.
Yeah.
They have been working pay-as-you-throw for 4 years.
Yeah.
I asked him enforcement questions.
Uh-huh.
How did you enforce it? He says, well, you know, he talked about the amnesty period where they tagged bags. They picked everything up for a week. They took away all the bags but one and put a sticker on it the second week. Then they left them.
Yep.
But Concord didn't have any problems. He says, I can't think of a single problem we've had. We didn't have, he says, I'm sure we had, especially initially, some dumping in commercial dumpsters, but I had no complaints.
Yeah.
The people bought the bags, they put the bags out there, and they seem to be happy with it. They're not receiving complaints. The revenue not only pays for their solid waste program, mm-hmm, and the hauling of recyclables, but also pays for the library in the city of Concord. Their recycling rate is 42% compared to what it was. So they have 42% recycling. More things are capable of being recycled, but they can't be recycled if the plants are taking them to now. Some plants will accept things that other plants won't.
Right.
42% of Concord's garbage, which was like 25,000 tons or whatever, is being diverted. So, hallelujah, they took like half their garbage basically out of the waste stream. Let me see. I asked him what he did about downtown, because I didn't understand how the downtown operated.
Isn't this a conversation we could have on Tuesday? I don't mean to be rude, but I'm about ready to pass out.
Well, then I fold.
I fold.
I'm not. I'm ready to walk away from pay-as-you-throw and garbage altogether. This has been nothing but... No, don't say nothing.
Don't. Not worth it. We understand, but it's been a very late
this is
day.
It's a very frustrating thing for me. These bags.
I can't even.
These bags are the sample of the boxes and bag things,
mm-hmm,
and a sample of what comes with the boxes and bags.
There's some down in Tim's office.
Those are the ones in Tim's office.
Oh, well, there's like five of these.
There were two by the time I got there. Whatever happened, I don't know.
Oh, no, there's three. There's five of them.
Those are copies of the material that would go in with the sleeves.
This is the...
This is what you buy. Just like those bags that I had with five bags inside, big bags, little bags, they're on a roll. It's got, we can put whatever we want on there for printing. You guys can disperse those or whatever. Those are the... You got the Waste Zero bags there. This is an orange bag from the other company.
This one made my dressing.
Are these as heavy as the other bags we looked at?
I don't know if these are the same mill, but we can get whatever.
What mill is this?
1.12 mill.
Okay, that's the next size down from that one, but we can get them in whatever sizes we want, or whatever thickness we want, right up to contract.
Actually, that's
what the
one's
color, too.
Well, that's the color we're recommending. They need to be brightly colored and easily identifiable.
Well, I like this color.
These here are from Peterborough, but they'll get printed whatever they want.
The other one has a mill on them. This one doesn't.
I got quotes from Sarah Bernier for just bags with and without the fulfillment. We'll talk about that on Tuesday.
Okay.
They,
it doesn't.
Okay.
Nope.
When is recycling meeting again?
I want to say Monday.
Can you send me a text to us what time and
I want to send it to the board.
Okay, because I want to see if I can make that one this time.
Needless to say, Sarah Bernier from Waste Zero, who was going to make a presentation, was called off. And our dealings with Waste Zero are now with the proposal that got sent out. You guys can take a look at that and see what that does to you. I don't have the contract from these people, and we do have another one coming.
Okay.
So we couldn't make a decision on Waste Zero tonight anyway.
Right, no. And I want to give it justice, so this way we can read this stuff and then...
I want to do it right. God knows, I want to get it done, but I want to do it right.
Oh, I understand, but it doesn't help that none of us have read everything that you read, so...
True enough.
And I'm just sort of like...
I'm very excited about this. I'm extremely excited about this, so...
I'm thinking July and August.
I want to learn as much as I can.
I'm thinking July and August.
And that's why I said Tuesday, because as soon as we get the contract done Tuesday, we're fine.
If you don't delay it longer, then July and August will be all set.
Right.
And bear in mind, there's a 60. You're going to see a figure about $6,800 in Waste Zero setup fee or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the cost. In that setup fee is 100 cases of the bags printed. All right. It's not just to like set up their computer graphics or whatever.
Right.
That includes all of the 3 months worth of bags, approximately. I make a motion, we adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor?
Oh.
Aye.
You want to kill the camera?
I would love to kill the camera.
And several other things with it?
Not physically, but bye-bye.